Hi, my name is Jason, and I'm an application engineer here at 3M. Today we're bringing you the second video in our standard operating procedure series on Feather, Prime, and Block. In the first video in this series, we prepped this panel for primer. So we sanded everything down, we feathered out our repair, we cleaned the panel, and we got it fully masked and ready for primer. Our masking has nice soft edges all the way around to make sure we don't get a hard edge when we're applying our primer. Before you apply primer, always be sure to check your paint company's technical data sheet and SOP process for that specific product. There's a lot of variation in the primers that are out there on the market today. Some primers, like the one we're going to be using in this video, is a direct-to-metal surfacing primer. That means we can spray directly over our bare metal and our repair area without any other steps to that process. With other primers that are out there, the bare metal must be treated first, either with an etching primer, a pre-treatment wipe, or in some cases, epoxy primer. Again, for the primer we're using today, we can get right into our primer application. The first thing we're gonna do is clean and blow off our panel using a wax and grease remover. I'm gonna use a wet cloth and a dry cloth, the wet one to wipe it off, the dry one to immediately follow and clean off the solvent. And right before I spray, with a little bit of air pressure, I'll blow off any contaminants that may have settled on the surface. Because it's already masked up, at that point I can begin applying primer. There's a few things you should always keep in mind when applying primer. The first thing is you want to make sure your gun is set up properly. Make sure your spray pressure is high as recommended by your gun manufacturer, and the smallest atomizing tip size that your paint company recommends for that primer. When we actually get to applying the primer, we want to make sure we use an outside to inside technique. What I mean by that is I'll be applying primer all the way out close to the edges of my masking with the first coat. The second coat will be in a little bit smaller than that. And then the third and final coat will be directly over the repair area, smaller than the second coat was. The reason we do that is we keep our overspray to the outside. If you sprayed small first, just over the repair area, that dry overspray is gonna settle around the repair. Another important thing with primer is to make sure you're allowing the proper flash time in between coats. If you apply your second coat before the first has fully flashed off, you can end up trapping solvents down inside of that primer. I'm going to get my PPE on, get my primer mixed, and start applying the primer. All right, now our primer has been baked, we can look at our edges. And this is what we're looking for towards the edge of our primer application area. We want a nice smooth transition from our unprimered area to our primered area. That's gonna make blocking go a lot faster. We also use that outside to in technique, and that gives us a nice smooth texture on top of the primer. That's again gonna make sanding go a lot faster. So that finishes our video on primer application. Be sure to check out our next video on the blocking side of this process. Thank you for watching. Be sure to comment, share, and subscribe. And for more content like this, be sure to check us out online at 3M Collision Repair Academy, a link to which can be found in the description below.